Chicago, you know things are getting weird in Chicago when the Cubs drank shots of whiskey before their three-game series against the St. Louis Cardinals, and the Cardinals volunteered to put their historic rivalry to rest, even suggesting they celebrate together Sunday at Wrigley Field. Strange times, indeed, this wacky final weekend in the National League. The Cubs are gathering their party favors as they lowered their magic number to 2 on Friday with an 8-4 victory over the Cardinals. They expanded their NL Central lead to 1.5 games before the Milwaukee Brewers took the field Friday night against the Detroit Tigers, and potentially can clinch their third consecutive division title Saturday. Yet, for a team that has taken team parties to another level, the Cubs' celebration has been, well, a little awkward. It dawned on the Cubs on Thursday that they never got around to celebrating their playoff berth when they clinched at least a wild card spot Wednesday night with their victory over the Pittsburgh Pirates. They planned to wait and celebrate in style after they clinch the NL Central title, but what happens if they don't win it, and the Brewers are the division champs? They would be in the playoffs, for the fourth consecutive year, but wouldn't have celebrated their accomplishment. So Cubs manager Joe Maddon rounded up his players Thursday afternoon, and told them no matter what transpired during their game that evening, they were going to at least have a mini celebration. The Cubs won, increasing their lead to one full game over the idle Brewers, passed around glasses filled with whiskey before reporters entered the room, and toasted their season. "We had them all in the big circle of the clubhouse," Maddon said, "and I wanted to praise them and congratulate them for the work they've done. So why in the world didn't they celebrate Wednesday when they officially clinched their playoff berth?" "A lot of the guys were gone," Maddon said, "when I figured things out." More MLB. Addison Russell's ex-wife says she wasn't ready to discuss abuse allegations last year. MLB extends Addison Russell's administrative leave to end of season. Joe Maddon's Addison Russell comments show baseball has much to learn about domestic abuse. The truth is that Maddon didn't know the Cubs had even clinched until reporters told him during his post-game news conference, and by that time, it was too late to plan anything. "Is it too late to have a full-fledged party, even if the Brewers wind up winning the division title?" "Not at all," Maddon said. "That's what I'm hearing. Again, I'm not in charge. Check with Angela, she's got it." That is Angela, the character in The Office, who planned the parties for the Dunder Mifflin Company. "Well, if you think that's goofy, how about turning their potential division-clinching celebration into the most bizarre in baseball history? These two rivals, filled with hatred over the last century, actually hugging and spraying champagne on one another someday? I would love that," Cardinals manager Mike Schilt said. "Let's do it." The concept isn't as far-fetched as it seems. Teams say the Cubs enter Sunday needing only a victory or a Brewers loss to clinch the NL Central. Say the Cardinals need only a victory Sunday to clinch the second wildcard berth over the Los Angeles Dodgers. And say the Cardinals win, but the Brewers also lose to the Tigers. If that happens, you're going to see Cardinals rushing onto the field, celebrating their playoff berth. And the Cubs mobbing one another, celebrating their division title. Wrigley Field will turn into a love fest, with fans wearing Cardinals red and Cubs blue hugging and dancing together down the aisles. Can you imagine? Well, while the dual celebration makes great theater, the Cubs would just as soon win out, not only winning the division, but eliminating the Cardinals. "I haven't even thought of that," Maddon says, "but it's a very alert time of the year. You have this heightened state of alert." Cubs starter Kyle Hendricks took the suspense out of this game early with his latest masterpiece, limiting the Cardinals to just 7 hits and 2 earned runs in 8 innings, and lowering his ERA to 1.66 in his last 8 starts. Hendricks, who has pitched a career-high 199 innings this season, now has gone 18 consecutive starts without walking more than 2 batters in a game. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and activate the bell button.